In the land of Hyrule, there are many treasures beyond imagining, but one of the most magical of them all is the Wind Waker. With this mysterious conductor's baton, one is able to harness the power of the wind itself to do either great good or great mischief. This artifact, which once was used by the King of Hyrule to direct the sages, has now passed to the Princess Zelda, who wields it in order to help the battles facing her country. Let's soar right in and see what it can do. Zelda's standard attack with the baton consists of 7 strikes. She will swipe up and left, spin and swipe up and right, swipe left, right, spin downwards with a spiraling gust of wind, summon up 3 whirlwinds in front of her from right to left, and finish with an even bigger circular gust. Something unique to this weapon is that Zelda herself doesn't move while doing any of these attacks, not one single inch. Being honest, the fact that Zelda doesn't budge while attacking is a fatal flaw for this weapon right out of the gate. Even if you are just in a one-on-one fight, the forward's momentum when using your standard attacks is incredibly important, as it constantly displaces where you once were, meaning that your foes will not always have perfect aim when they want to hit you. Zelda is incredibly vulnerable whenever she's standard attacking, and on top of this, her lack of movement means that she will need to constantly reposition herself when taking on groups, or simply just following up on higher health foes. Throwing gas onto this tire fire of a standard string is her relatively slow initial attacks, which have a slight pause between them, making her not ideal for even just following up on stunned enemies, where you at least know they're not gonna move. Basically, any potential that she could have is shot in the foot by her lack of movement. This, in my opinion, is the worst standard attack string in the game, just from a lack of utility alone. Okay, well, let's go ahead and move on to her heavy attack and combos. By hitting heavy attack, Zelda will send out several fast-moving tornadoes in a fan pattern in front of her. From there, she will stay put while she directly controls a small tornado to attack her enemies, and she can end this control by hitting heavy attack again, which will make her tornado burst. There is a slightly random effect to the initial tornadoes, which makes smaller wind gusts appear near your enemies. If you are able to pilot your tornado to these, it will cause it to grow and become much more powerful. There is a lot of potential in this attack, but its usage is incredibly specific. It's best used when you are just at the entrance to a keep with nobody who can attack you from behind. You are actually able to clear entire forts with just this one move, as long as you are able to swiftly grow your tornado and keep yourself from being rushed from the front. Zelda's first heavy attack combo has her bring in 3 electric notes, which chain lightning between them before Zelda zaps her enemies to the front. This combo serves as both a launcher and electric damage. However, its entire animation is a bit sluggish. Zelda's second combo has her float upwards before sending off several volleys of electricity in a musical bar shape. This attack again has quite a bit of a windup, but it does have good reach and control, and it is effective at destroying groups charging at you. Zelda's third combo has her quickly perform a series of large wind swipes before finishing with a little twirl forwards. Unlike most third combos, this one is not very good at area damage, but it does do the job on small and wide groups that are right in your face, or simply on single targets that are in front of you. Zelda's fourth combo has her perform a quick whirlwind under her, which propels her up into the sky before she comes gracefully down once more. This one is more of a proper crowd clearer, however, the fact that she uses it directly under her, and the fact that she wouldn't have moved at all while getting to it, lessens its effectiveness considerably. Zelda's fifth and final combo has her float up and sweep large gusts of musical energy before finishing with a big spiral of wind on the way down. Unlike her fourth combo, this one actually does have the range to make up for her lack of movement getting to it, and it is her best area clearer by far. Finishing off her kit is her fourth special attack, which has Zelda summon in winds from the left and right and cause a large tornado just in front of her. This attack is easy to aim, affects a large area, and is quite strong. When we put all of Zelda's kit together, it seems like almost everything she could do is just ruined by her terrible standard attack string. This might seem like a small thing to keep going on about, but the way that a character handles in these 5 or 7 weak attacks can make or break an entire fighter. Zelda does have some pretty good combos to work towards, but it means next to nothing if she isn't getting proper positioning to her enemies before unleashing them. For this reason, only her attacks which have some actual range to them, meaning her second, final, and her fourth special attack, are able to be called even mediocre. This is a low tier, bottom 10 pick at best, and as usual for these cases of wasted potential, I think that it is just such a shame for what could have been an amazing playstyle.
I've caught you at last! We are the sons of the boss! I am the pain.